So all our habitat types in Missouri, whether it's prairie or woodland, forest, wetland, those habitat types evolve with the use of fire over the time. Mainly lightning strikes or Native Americans setting those fires. And I look at fire no different than like a disc or a chainsaw. It's another management tool in the toolbox. And the biggest advantage being you can get over a lot of ground in a hurry, and it's a cheap and effective tool.
We are doing a controlled burn on about 89 acres of timber. So our goal is to promote native growth of native warm season grasses and forbs. We got a good stand going here already, but this burn hopefully will get some more seed germination. And it's all stuff that the wildlife that are native to this area like, deer and turkey and quail. That's our prime goal here.
As we're lightning running up, if the wind starts pushing things that way, you don't want it to get in front of you, so you just kind of keep lighting along the road. So you'll need one drip torch.
Yep. Right. One. Yep.
The skid unit and then rakes.
Yep. I think that would do it.
Yeah. So the hardest part of burning is always getting enough people to do it. Enough people, especially enough people who've been trained and kind of know what they're doing. So the PBA is Upper Merrimack Prescribed Burn Association, and a godsend for landowners to be able to get work done that would be awful hard to do by yourself.
So the burn associations are basically neighbors helping neighbors. A prescribed burn association actually allows you to draw from a bigger group of people that go out and help each other with prescribed burns on their property. In addition to that, you know, the Department of Conservation has been supporting our prescribed burn associations with grants to provide the equipment that they need to safely conduct prescribed burns as well.
You want a natural material like leather. You don't want any like cloth type stuff. It'll typically burn, or you can get some embers in it and you'll poke a nice
hole. My husband and I recently purchased some land, and part of that plan for the land was to burn. And initially we didn't think it was going to be possible. We thought we were going to have to contract it out. We're like, this is too much. I was really nervous about, you know, the thought of setting something on fire. So I reached out to the MDC and said, hey, you know, do you know of anybody who does prescribed burns, or, you know, are there classes that we can take? And they put us in contact with the Upper Merrimack Prescribed Burn Association.
So within our private land program here with the Missouri Department of Conservation, we've got a lot of things we can offer landowners. We've got private land biologists and foresters that can come out and meet with the landowners on site to go over their goals and objectives and put plans together. We also offer landowner prescribed fire burn workshops, part of which is an online resource. And then we do a field day where they actually get to come out and use specialized equipment for conducting prescribed burns and help us do a prescribed fire that day.
I think it is a little bit intimidating to think about doing this. And there's a lot of things that factor into this, right? Like the weather, you know, the topography, like all these different factors.
And,
you know, we're just now learning a lot about all that stuff.
Yeah, I mean, hopefully we can make some connections through these sorts of classes. And, you know, hopefully we can do it on other people's property first, right? Okay, I think that's the idea, right?
Yeah.
That we get some experience.
So in 2021, the Missouri Prescribed Fire Act became law. Basically what that law does is it says a landowner or a landowner's agent has to be proven negligent to be liable for damages associated with prescribed fire. And there's a number of different things that landowners can do to ensure that they're not negligent. One of those is going through training, such as the Missouri Prescribed Fire training that MDC provides for private landowners. Another is having a written burn plan and then following that burn plan. Burn plans provide things like it identifies the unit, the objectives of the prescribed burn, the weather parameters that are necessary, the number of people, the number of resources that are needed to properly conduct that prescribed burn. And the other thing is we have a lot of resources here in Missouri provided either by the Department of Conservation or some of our partners that actually provide a number of different resources, whether it be technical assistance to go out and visit with the landowner, identify their objectives, help them identify where prescribed burn lines would be best suited to meet their needs, but also to even provide cost share or assistance with writing a burn plan and things like that to assist landowners with conducting burns safely on their property.
Let's do introductions so we all can get a little familiar with each other. I'm Joe Heller.
That's my wife, Brandy. My son, Abel.
Gary Patterson. I'm a member of Upper Merrimack Prescribed Burn Association.
I'm Abby Orr. We are part of the Upper Merrimack Prescribed Burn Association, and we have some property off BB and Steelville.
Andy Orr, Abby's husband. There's property, like she said. And we're, thanks for having us. This is our first burn.
All right, let's do our test fire. Well, I'm pretty comfortable with how it looks. Looks like we have a pretty much a straight, close to straight south wind. If you guys want to start running with it, we'll kind of just post up here for a minute and work our way down a little bit. I think that'll be good. Today we are burning 7.5 acres of a prairie restoration unit that I did. This used to be a cool season grass pasture, and we wanted to convert it over to pollinator-friendly planting. That'd be good for monarchs, and it's good for deer and turkey and songbirds and pretty well everything.
Yeah, well, I've been able to light the drip torch and create a fire line. It's been really helpful having everyone here and actually being on a site and doing a burn, because I'm able to ask lots of questions.
How much of this black do you want before you start lighting?
Yeah, so 40 feet of black, and then, you know, you can add that, you know, to your the distance of your fire line.
Okay. Kind of think about how we'd be burning our own land. But I'm really thankful that Joe had us out today, because I think this has been really insightful.
So we started a Prescribed Burn Association last year. It's up to about 50 members now. We've got just neighbors helping neighbors. It's really made it easy to get these burns done. In the past, sometimes it could be a challenge finding enough people to get a crew together where you can burn safely and or burn whatever size acreage you need. We're all putting a lot of good habitat on the ground together.
It's been a relatively controlled burn. I was kind of surprised that, you know, it was less exciting than I thought it would be, in a good way.
You know, as is well known, Missouri is a 93% privately owned state. So getting prescribed fire on the landscape, if you're not looking at private lands, you're not relevant. Prescribed burn associations are is it's a group of landowners, so they can be very focused or they can be at a county or multi-county scale, and it's just a group of folks, you know, private landowners interested in doing prescribed burning. I think we went from 4 to 10 pretty quick, and I think we're at 14 or 15 now with 4 others that are, you know, popping up even. So we're going to have pretty much in a short period of time statewide coverage, which is awesome.
There's fire line about 10 feet from the fencing. So I believe we're starting the northwest corner. So I think we have southeast winds, which is good because we don't want it over the road.
Well, it's excited. We're excited to get started on it. We're super grateful for all the help we have. It was a little bit nervous, a new experience, but really grateful to have all the help that we have and excited that we're finally doing it.
Feels good. There's a lot of work leading up to this, that's for sure. A lot of help from all these people. Really appreciate that. So,
and it was nice. We had the MPC workshop. We learned a ton. And then we were invited to come on multiple burns, and it just kind of reinforced what we learned. So, and you know, today, having seen a couple, that's kind of where the confidence comes from. I'm like, I trust the folks that we're burning with, and so I feel good about the burn today.